Okay, so yes, say hi, Caleb. Oh, you got what car have you got? Is that okay? I'm setting up here to make a product for my customers. This is focus. Focus, stupid camera. All right. So that's a that is a nose bearing for an F1D, and so we sell these, and the intent here is to kind of try at least to show you how these are built. The individual wanted a 13,000th diameter. So I always, because I have lots of wire hanging around, I'm always having to refresh my memory as to what's what. So I have this tool. I'm the third owner of this thing. You see this? This is a nice tool. This is better than like your dial calipers or what have you. These things are legit. Like I said, I'm about the third owner of it. This thing has pretty good provenance, and it's not. I don't think it's stock either. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to stick this piece of wire in here. You see that? It's showing about 16,000th. I know for a fact this is not 16,000th wire because I bought this. It's 15. There may be some. Oh yeah, there's some. A little bit of oxidation on that end. Close enough. I use steel wire on this stuff. And that's just kind of part of the nature of the beast. What we're going to do here is we're going to set this thing up to handle a 15,000th inch shaft. So what I'm doing here, I have to turn this down here. I just have to look at my chest. Off this little piece of wire, I'm going to cross this over. That piece of wire becomes my mandrel here. If you have any sensibilities about making things out of wire, don't watch this video. That's just all there is. Just hit stop now. Just hit stop now. Is going to be that bad. I make these good enough to sell this way. Sorry. Here we go. So, got these crossed over like so. I'm gonna just bend this thing around. So you see, I've got a kind of a sloppy coil so far. I'm gonna back this thing further down here. I'm gonna pull this around. Keep pulling it around until I get a full, nice. You see that? I don't know if it shows up real well. See if we can get focus. Now, I've got this on the right side. It does not matter which side it's on, but if you're gonna do it on the right side, you want to grab this, grab it right here, and bend it to its center because you're gonna want the airplane pulling to the left anyway. Now, I never sell this one because I use this one as a template. In case you're wondering. Our templates around here at J&H Aerospace are just the parts. So, here we go. Come on, you can do it. Now, sent it flying. Can't lose that. I don't want to get out an F1D and measure them. This one's just based off of those. Right, so grab this, bend it around. Bend it around the same side, like so. Back a little. See? Makes sense. I'm going to grab it again. This is the hard part. It doesn't like to stay put. You just got to strong arm this thing around. I've got a little bit extra. I'll clip that off too. There you go. Now you have to straighten this thing because you want it to move freely. Moving freely back there. Now, in actuality, it's only going to get used on thinner wire. And see. Bingo. Now, all you have to do at this point is polish the end of it with the Dremel tool. And you're good. Off to the races. Hope that helps. Otherwise, just pay me to make them. Just that way, you don't have to see all that awful stuff. Just pay me to do it. Okay. But if you want to, that's how you make them. That's all there is.